Hey everyone, welcome back to the North American Challenger Series Spring Playoffs. We're headed into Game 2 of the finals, so this is best of 5, between Cloud9 Tempest and LMQ. But first, I'd like to welcome the original Cloud9 mid laner, Hi, to the analyst desk. Hey man, so he's going to be breaking down some of the action for us. So, picks and bans, 380 carry bans, what's up with that?
Right, so picks and bans went extremely well for C9T that game. One, LMQ banned Corki randomly, and then C9T banned 3. That happened. They had a few OPs still left open, so they had a choice between like picking Kha'Zix, Lucian, or like Soraka, and even like Thresh, I guess. So if they first picked Lucian, C9T would get back Soraka and Kha'Zix. If they first picked Kha'Zix, C9T would get Lucian, Soraka, like they did. So the pick and ban phase went very well for C9, and I think that was a huge part of the game, basically. It put Vasili on Ezreal, which is a fine champion, but he's definitely not a top-tier champion, and it kind of showed that game. He kind of went on tilt when he fell behind, and it just went really well for C9.
Yeah, so then actually you kind of play into the game and you've got all these like mid-game advantages, like every single fight turned by a wish. Like it seems one of the big strengths of Soraka. I feel like that'll be a really valuable champion in the next pick and ban phase.
Right, so in that game as well, talking about picks again, all LMQ wanted to do that game was basically team fight. They had Orianna, Leona, Kha'Zix, and Ezreal. They're only good for team fighting, and you're not going to beat a Soraka team in team fighting. She's the king of team fighting, or a queen, I guess, since she's a girl. But when you pick a team fighting team comp, you need to be able to win the team fights, and you're just not going to win against triple heal and Soraka. Mm-hmm. So multiple times throughout that game, they just kept getting baited by heal, and it's extremely annoying to play versus, and C9 just played that extremely well.
Yeah, and I feel like Soraka is even more strong against LMQ than it would be against other mid laners, because Xiaoyixiao, he's known for just farming very, very hard. And there's going to be other fights on the other side of the map that normally, you know, he's not going to be able to get to because he's not going to roam there. But Soraka can add her wish in. And that's really where they got their mid-game advantages, was from wishes that won fights where the mid laners didn't really have an impact. You know, they're just farming away in mid lane, but Soraka's actually adding something to the rest of the team. Do you think Soraka is specifically better against Xiaoyixiao since he's so focused on farming?
I would say when you're playing against Xiaoyixiao, he likely won't lose his lane for one.
Oh, yeah.
He'll likely outfarm you.
Well.
Yeah, he CSs very well, but for him to do that, he farms Wolves and Raves, so he drops entire map pressure. He drops vision pressure. Mm-hmm. So instead of trying to beat him in lane, you just go and pressure the other lanes. While Bishu didn't do that, he didn't have to because of Soraka. He can press ultimate and bam. He can win a top lane fight. He can win a bot lane fight from just doing that. So when you're playing against him, you should look to control vision, and you look just to control the map control, basically. Because you're not going to control lane against a guy that only wants to farm.
Because
what are you going to do? Tower dive him? You're not going to do that. So you just want to take over vision, ward up their jungle, take away their vision, and force bot and top to fight and do something about it.
Do you think it's more of a strategic sort of gameplay change than like, oh, well, you can pick like these three champions and they'll excel? It's more like your mindset to approach the mid game?
It's definitely while champions can help, I think it's just a strategical thing. Say, for example, Bishu had or LeBlanc or something, for example. Even with LeBlanc, I wouldn't be trying to win my lane against an Orianna, because Orianna can always play a passive, and especially on Xiaoyixiao. For him to die, he'd have to make a mistake, and I'm not relying on the enemy pro player to make a mistake. Mm. It can happen, but you can't rely on that. So instead of doing that, you should play around their weaknesses. His weakness is he doesn't leave mid lane, so take advantage of that. Ward their jungle, make their jungler feel pressured, go bot, do something. And just basically punish them for not doing anything.
So now that Cloud9 Tempest do have the advantage, they came out with a great early plan in game one, and they've got LMQ kind of on tilt, or you know, maybe at a mental disadvantage because of coming out with a loss. How do you think Cloud9 can best roll this first win, this momentum, through a 5-game series?
So I want to say C9 can bring the momentum forward, but the issue with the pick and ban phase they just did, it's kind of a cheesy one, so it should only work once against LMQ. Since I was in the player lounge too, talking to their managers or whatever, so like they basically heard the strategy of what I told them, so I imagine they went and talked to their players and like let them know, hey, watch out for this. So I imagine they have a better plan in case C9 tries to do the exact same bans. So while their first game went really well, I think game two will be completely different just because LMQ will notice that the pick and ban phase in game one went very bad for them, and they're not going to let the same thing happen twice. So they'll basically change their bans and force C9 to have a bad phase.
All right, we'll see if it happens. Hi, thank you very much for your time. Of course, we'll see you after the next game as well, but we're going to get ourselves into Champions League in just a second for the